Now we have moved to write jQuery code for add blank row for enter one more item details. So in jQuery code, first we have defined final total amount variable is equal to dollar with span tag id final total amount with text method. This code will get value of final total amount and store into this variable. Below this we have defined one count variable is equal to 1, so when we have click on add row button then this count variable value will be increased by 1. After this we have write $document selector with on method and under this method we have right click event with button add row, so when we have click on add row button then this code will execute. Under this first we want to increase value of count variable by 1, so we have write count variable is equal to count variable plus 1. Then after we have write dollar with hidden field at total item with value method and under method we have write count variable, so here we have defined count variable value to this hidden field value. Now we have defined one HTML code variable is equal to blank value, under this variable we will store HTML code for blank table row for enter item details. So now we have write HTML code variable and under this we have append HTML code like open table row tag with attribute it is equal to row id with value of count variable. After this we have again write HTML code variable and under this we have append code table data tagged with span it is equal to serial no and between span tag we have write count variable. For enter item name details we have write HTML code variable and in this variable we have append HTML code like input type is equal to text with attribute name is equal to item name. It is equal to item name with dynamic value of count variable so it will generate on jQuery. Same way for enter item quantity we have write HTML code variable and in this variable we have append HTML code like table data tagged with input type is equal to text with attribute name is equal to order item quantity. It is equal to order item quantity with count variable value. Data serial no is equal to count variable value and class is equal to number only and order item quantity. After we have write HTML code variable and in this variable we have append code like table data tagged with input type is equal to text, name is equal to order item price, it is equal to order item price with count variable value. Data serial number is equal to also count variable and class is equal to number only and order item price. Then after for item actual amount we have write HTML code variable and in this variable we have append code like table data tagged with input type is equal to text, name is equal to order item actual amount, it is equal to order item actual amount with count variable. Data serial number is equal to count variable and class is equal to order item actual amount with read only attribute. For enter tax one rate we have write HTML code and in variable we have append code like table data tagged with input type is equal to text, name is equal to order item tax one rate, it is equal to order item tax one rate with count variable value. Data serial number is equal to count variable and class is equal to number only and order item tax one rate. Same way for display tax one amount we have write HTML code variable and in this we have append code like table data tagged with input type is equal to text name is equal to order item tax one amount, it is equal to order item tax one amount with count variable. Data serial number is equal to count with read only attribute and class is equal to order item tax one amount. For enter tax 2 rate we have write HTML code and in variable we have append code like table data tagged with input type is equal to text, Name is equal to order item tax to rate. It is equal to order item tax to rate with count variable value. Data serial number is equal to count variable and class is equal to number only and order item tax to rate. Same way for display tax to amount, we have write HTML code variable and in this we have append code like table data tagged with input type is equal to text name is equal to order item tax to amount. It is equal to order item tax to amount with count variable. Data serial number is equal to count with read only attribute and class is equal to order item tax to amount. For enter tax 3 rate, we have write HTML code and in variable we have append code like table data tagged with input type is equal to text. Name is equal to order item tax 3 rate. It is equal to order item tax 3 rate with count variable value. Data serial number is equal to count variable and class is equal to number only and order item tax 3 rate. Same way for display tax 3 amount we have write HTML code variable and in this we have append code like table data tagged with input type is equal to text. Name is equal to order item tax 3 amount. It is equal to order item tax 3 amount with count variable. Data serial number is equal to count with read only attribute and class is equal to order item tax 3 amount. Then after for display particular item total we have write HTML code and in this variable we have append code like table data tagged with input type is equal to text. Name is equal to order item final amount. It is equal to order item finale amount count variable. Data serial number is equal to count variable with read only attribute and class is equal to order item final amount. And lastly, we want to define one button for remove table row. So we have write HTML code and in this variable we have append code like table data tagged with button tagged with type is equal to button. Name is equal to remove row. It is equal to count variable value and class is equal to remove row. By clicking on this row we can remove table row. So this way we have append all HTML code for append blank table row for enter item details into this HTML code variable. So now we have write dollar with table lid invoice item table with append method and in this method we have write HTML code variable. This code will append blank table into table. Now we have move to write jQuery code for remove row. So we have write dollar with document selector with on method and under this method we have write click event with button class remove row. So when we have click on remove row button then this code will execute. Under this first we have write row id variable is equal to dollar this with attribute method and under this method we have write id. This code will fetch it attribute value and store into this row id variable. After this we have write total item amount variable is equal to dollar with text box id order item final amount with row id variable value with value method. This method will fetch particular item total amount and store into this total item amount. Then after we have write final amount variable is equal to dollar with spanned final total amount with text method. This code will fetch final total amount value and store into this final amount variable. Now we have write result amount variable is equal to parse float final amount minus parse float total item amount. This code will minus total item amount from final amount and store into result amount variable. Here when we have removed particular row then we want to minus that row total amount from final total amount so we have write this code. and for display result amount variable value into span tag with id final total amount, so we have write dollar with span tag id final total amount with text method, and under this method we have write result amount variable. So it will display updated amount under final total amount after removing table row. Then after for remove whole table row, so we have write dollar with table row id with remove method. This method will remove particular table row with content from table. Now we want to reduce value of count variable after removing particular table row, so we have write count variable is equal to count variable minus 1. And that count variable value we want to assign hidden field total item, so we have write dollar with hidden field id total item with value method, and under this method we have write count variable. So this code will assign current value of count variable to hidden field id total item. In next part we will make one jQuery function which can calculate item actual amount, tax 1 amount, tax 2 amount, tax 3 amount and final invoice total amount. If you have any query regarding this video tutorial part, please comment your query in comment box, and if you like this video tutorial please share with your friends, or even you can also share on social media also. If you want to get more update regarding our video tutorial, please subscribe our YouTube channel for get more update regarding release of future video. Lastly, keep watching our YouTube channel. Thanks for watching this video tutorial.